I'm Ben with Sentry Software, and today I'm going to show you how to monitor your devices with the Hardware Sentry OpenTelemetry Collector. If you're not familiar with the OpenTelemetry Collector, it's a free-to-use solution that can monitor the hardware of hundreds of different server, networking, and storage platforms, and can feed that data into different monitoring solutions, including Prometheus, Grafana, and BMC Helix. So now let's take a look at how that monitoring is set up. So this is the config folder of the OpenTelemetry Collector, and in here you'll see this hws-config file. This is what contains all of your configuration for your hardware monitoring. So the collector ships with this example file, and if we take a look at that, what we'll see here is that you've got a label for your site, you've got some extra metrics here for your carbon density and electricity cost. These are used by the sustainable IT component to compute your annual energy usage and carbon emissions. And then below that, we have the targets. So these are the systems you're going to be monitoring. And you see it's broken into sections based on the protocol that's going to be used to connect to the system. So all you need to do in here is specify some very basic information about the system for the collector to be able to connect to it. You need to specify a hostname or IP address. You need to specify the system type. For example, this one is OOB, meaning out of band. That's a management card. There's some other ones here, such as Windows, Linux, etc. And then beyond that, it's just protocol-specific information that you need to specify. So a username, a password, SNMP, you'd need to specify the community string. You don't need to put your passwords in this file in plain text. We have a utility called hws-encrypt, that's in the bin folder. You can launch that from a command line, type in your password, and it'll return an encrypted version of it that you can use in these configuration files. So if we take a look at one that I've already configured, I've got some targets here, and these are all just common systems. So this is an old IBM X series up here. This is an HP ProLiant using SNMP. This is a Cisco UCS series using SNMP. Dell PowerEdge would also use SNMP, so the configuration would look very similar. And then down here, just a couple more ProLiants that are using HTTP. So let's take a look at what these monitored systems would look like and what kind of metrics would be exposed for them. I have this collector hooked up to Prometheus and Grafana, so we'll look at both. First, in Prometheus, this is the graph page. All of the metrics begin with HW, so if you just start typing that, you see we've got a huge list. These are all of the monitored metrics. So for example, we can look at CPU status. You see this is the status of all of those CPUs of those monitored systems. And we see that right now these are all reporting zero, which means okay. And we see the same thing on the graph here as well. And you can do the same thing for any of the other metrics. If we look at Grafana, if we go to the dashboards here, we have a pre-built sustainable IT dashboard, and that's going to give you your annual energy cost, your CO2 emissions, etc. And if you scroll down on this page, it's broken down into the individual sites. So if we choose our site, we can see all the devices we had configured there. And if we choose one of those, we can see all of its monitored components. So here, let's look at the physical disks. We see we have one drive that's okay, and then this is an example of a drive that would be failed. And if you wanted to be alerted on a failure like this, you could use either the Grafana alerting rules or the Prometheus alert manager to notify you when a component fails. So it really can be that simple to set up a powerful, capable, and free-to-use monitoring solution. If you'd like to download the OpenTelemetry Collector, it's available on our website at sentrysoftware.com along with all of its documentation. And if you need a helping hand, we have support plans available. Also, check out our YouTube channel for more informative content, and thanks for watching.